In the last video, I covered the last three Street Fighter games.
We're halfway home, and now we get into the Street Fighter Alpha series.
The date is June 27th, 1995, and we get Street Fighter Alpha for the arcades. What many may not know is that this game serves as a bridge between Street Fighter and Street Fighter 2.
That's kind of interesting if you think about it.
For starters, the character roster took quite a cut from 16 characters to 10 playable characters. The graphics also got a complete makeover. Most notably, the characters look more like anime characters. While on topic of characters, we only see the return of Ryu, Ken, Chun-Li, Sagat, Akuma, and M. Bison. Adon and Birdie return after an 8-year hiatus. What's more surprising is that Guy and Sadam from Final Fight make their Street Fighter debut.
Considering that Capcom owns both games, it would make sense to introduce both into the Street Fighter series.
The only true new debuts are Rose, an Italian fortune teller who wields soul power bent on destroying M. Bison's evil energy, and Charlie, Guile's comrade in arms.
Of course, there's everyone's favorite idiot, Dan Hibiki. It may be just me, but I really don't care for this character because he's a complete goof.
Super Combos return from Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo, but this game revamps it. Speaking of Super Combos, this ties into a new mechanic, playstyle. There are two styles, manual and auto. If you're new to the series, auto is the way to go. Purists would go with manual blocking.
What I mean is auto automatically blocks an attack for you, but only for a limited amount of times. Manual needs no explanation.
Super Combos with auto are easier to execute by pressing a punch and kick of the same strength simultaneously, but reduces the super combo gauge to 1. Another new mechanic is air blocking.
This means you can block an attack while jumping.
Another new mechanic is chain combo.
This means you perform one move, interrupt the animation to do another move. It's complicated to explain.
What's also new is that you fight 7 opponents instead of 12. Your final opponent depends on who you play as.
For the most part, it's M. Bison, but there are some exceptions.
Here's a complete list. Alpha counters make their debut. This is done by blocking an attack, move the directional pad from back to down, and press either punch or kick, depending on who you use. Sound is so-so, but gets the job done. There isn't anything else left to talk about. This game is great fun, and if you're looking for an interesting Street Fighter, this game's for you. This game gets 5 out of 5 stars. Now we move on to March 6, 1996, and the release of Street Fighter Alpha 2. Not much has changed from the first game. We see the debut of Sakura, a schoolgirl who not only idolizes Ryu, but also needs to either get a longer skirt or a pair of pants. Gen from the first Street Fighter game makes his return, and Dalsim and Zangief also make a comeback. Rolento from Final Fight makes an appearance as well.
Why those characters? Well, why not?
Speaking of characters, there is a mid-boss between fights, and who you fight depends on who you play as. Here is a list for those who are curious. Outside of those features, there isn't much else to say. While Alpha was good, this game's better. 5 out of 5 stars, moving on. We now move on to June 29th, 1998 with the release of Street Fighter Alpha 3.
You know, this game was released after Street Fighter 3. Weird.
Street Fighter Alpha 3's gameplay got quite a makeover. For starters, the styles are no longer manual or auto, but rather borrow from the previous three games. Like the last two games, we see the return of Balrog, Cammy, Vega, Blanca, and E. Honda. Cody from Final Fight makes his debut, but as a prisoner instead of a vigilante. We see the debut of Rainbow Mika, a pro wrestler who idolizes Zangief, Karin, Sakura's rival who also needs a longer skirt or a pair of pants, and Julie and Junie, two of M. Bison's Shadaloo dolls.
But when it comes to the roster as a whole, the arcade got the short end of the stick. Homeport releases got more characters.
But here's the real shocker, no Mike Hagar.
You mean to say that in 3 Alpha game releases, and no Mike Hagar? Seriously?
The rival battles return, but now there are 2 instead of 1, and they take place at the 5th and 9th battles. There's only one more thing that makes it a game apart from all others. Even if you lose the final fight, you win.
Huh. Even if you lose, you still beat the game.
No matter, all 3 Street Fighter Alpha games are great games. If you get your hands on this collection or any other, you'll get your money's worth. This game gets 5 stars out of 5. Stay tuned for the conclusion, the Street Fighter 3 series, and an overall impression of Street Fighter 30th Anniversary Collection.